Welcome friends to your own YouTube channel. In this video, we will see what really happened in PNB fraud case and what are alleys upon which this whole billions of dollars scam happened. So friends, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for latest updates. First, we have to understand what is LOU, that is letter of undertaking. LOUs are basically used by banks' customers to avail short-term credit in the foreign country. These transactions are not retail in nature and are mostly used by businesses for import of goods. Thus, LOUs are very popular in jewelry and gem industry. The borrower uses her existing credit relationship with a bank in India to avail the required credit outside the country. An authorized dealer like banks may give a guarantee or letter of undertaking in respect of any debt, obligation or other liability incurred by a person resident in India and owned to a person resident outside India for import of goods. So if the bank is convinced, it will issue an LOU which when given to an overseas branch of another Indian bank would result in release of the amount in foreign currency. This amount does not come in the customer's account directly. In fact, it goes to the nostro account. So the customer can decide in whose favor the payment needs to be done. Now, let's see what are the benefits of issuing LOUs. Friends, the most interesting part of LOUs is that every party in this whole process is at profit. How? Let's see. The overseas bank lending to the borrower based on the LOU earns interest on the amount which it lended. The bank issuing the LOU will also get a fee and the borrower gets a credit facility at a place where he may not have banking relationships. Moreover, interest rates in India are higher compared to the international benchmark rates. Thus, LOUs are very attractive with NRI businessmen. So the effective outgo on interest for the borrower is also beneficial. Fact of the matter is, everyone wins in issuing LOUs. Now, let's see what is the process that is normally followed to issue LOUs and transmit messages by SWIFT. Request for loans or LOUs for large amounts have to be approved by the senior management of any financial institution. The other part of the process is the transmission of messages. This is usually a three-layer process that takes place either at the branch or its controlling offices. One bank official is designated as a maker, the second one is verifier, and another one is authorizer. All have different logins and password, and the work is almost done independently of each other. So now comes the most important question. What went wrong in the PNB case? So even after so much due diligence, how a fraud worth billions of rupees took place in PNB? Let's see how it happened. Friends, SWIFT transactions are linked to the core banking solution of the banks, which contains the transaction histories and other data of all customers and can be accessed by all branches where a customer has an account. SWIFT transactions therefore are automatically recorded and are seen by officials from regional managers to general managers, and when the amount is big, the sanctioning is almost done by top management. In PNB case, the scamsters delinked the SWIFT from CBS in the case of companies that were linked to Nirav Modi and Mehul Chosky. However, LOUs of other companies were routed through the SWIFT CBS system. This meant that funds were provided to the Modi Chosky companies without being recorded in the bank CBS. Since the LOUs were given by the second largest public sector bank, that is PNB, hence, foreign banks also took the LOUs pretty good considering the image of PNB and the public sector tag. Thus, this is clear lapse of technology and giving unauthorized power to the staff, Though after this scam, PNB immediately upgraded its Finacle to version 10, but still the lapses show huge negligence. Friends, it's a huge lapse on auditors' front also. How this whole scam went under their eyes for so long. With numerous audits happening all these years, how come no one raised even a question? This indeed is a matter of serious concern. I consider this as a lapse not only of PNB but also of foreign banks who release the funds without checking the authenticity of these LOUs. Thus, it is vast network of negligence from not only from PNB but also from the foreign banks who release the funds. So friends, I thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe this channel for more updates. Thank you.